Hi everyone, this is LAR Games, and today I'm watching episode 6 of Symphogear. I wonder if this is that same location that we saw earlier with the naked lady who tortures people and speaks amazing English. But if it is the same place, I guess last time I didn't notice the kind of the structure of the place, which is a bit strange. It's like reminds me of a Half-Life a little bit, actually, with like old-timey looking like locations mixed with kind of what's the word? Shoot, it's not post-apocalyptic. It's dystopian sort of futuristic technology mixed in. But yeah, let's get started and see what this actually is. And make a big boom. Is this her thinking place? I guess even in the future, they can't stop, the slave trade? That was a good catch. Wouldn't that mean you have power? Would you crush yourself? Seems she doesn't need the dome anymore. That's good. Video games are pretty nice. No, she doesn't need it anymore. She doesn't want to be a bubble boy anymore. Also, that school is everything. Why is she beating you? You've been training all this time. Did it amount to nothing? All right, I guess she was going with the slow and steady approach. Oh, there's the scar from the thing. Also, this is one of the ones apparently where humanity doesn't have nipples. I feel that it might not be a very good location for plants. Wonder how much sunlight they get in there. You got some nice pancakes there. Okay, never mind. Don't ignore what I said. Well, she grabs hers. I guess that means his tie is on properly now. If that's what it had to take for him to do that, then it's a sacrifice I'm willing to take. Wonder what that means. Does the facility build itself? Do you have 3D printers in there? If you're literally the only thing that can stop these things, no matter how unofficial it is, you'd think it'd be official pretty fast. America. I wonder if that means we're going to hear some more anguish. Don't worry, she was just talking to her imaginary friend. Oh, she's bringing flowers to Broody Girl. Oh, she thought she was dead. Oh, that's what she saw. Yeah, that is pretty horrible. Why has nobody else been cleaning up, though? That's Araragi's job. I know he's from a different anime, but you could always give him a call. I'm sure he'll be more than happy to help. Can't be any worse than Kamaru's room. Why is You'd think that her like stuff would be a lot more private. Some people will disagree with you on that. Have they explained yet why she didn't actually help her? That's an interesting perspective. Though that might have, now that I think of it, that might have also been what was happening to her redheaded friend initially. I keep thinking she's gonna attack her with that cane. Is that a, what is that called? Arm brace? No, I mean, maliciously or anything, but like as a way to train her. But I don't think she has the strength to do that right now. I just keep imagining it. That's an odd shadow. Of course, she eats three times as much as anyone else. You really should get some other friends too. She's not that old. Oh. Is she still gonna be there by the time they come back? Can she leave? Uh-oh. Ah, dang it, his tie is back like that. Do we need to kill another politician? Uh-oh. Is she gonna die? No, she's gonna blow him back. Just stay there in the air, car. Just hold on. You know, I kind of imagine her reaction is like, oh my God, thank God she's just a superhero. I think she's just a regular sized one. She's a little on the bigger side, actually. I'm sure she knows her preferences and hobbies and measurements. They should probably take off the gloves then. Also, those aren't hands. Do they stack? What's that? Wait, what was that? How does she like grunting sounds while singing? Just, oh, okay. I thought she was gonna send out blasts, Dragon Ball style. Now that's an anime punch. I guess she's not as relieved as I thought. Well, I guess now she's more worried than anything, you know. Well, wonder how that's gonna go for next episode since she knows now. There's no mind wiping MIB style type thing, I think. So, yeah, I mean, if that was the case, they probably would have done it too. Hibiki a long time ago. No English this episode, so I didn't get that many laughs, so that was a little bit disappointing, especially when they mentioned the Americans. I was starting to get my hopes up, but maybe next episode. Yeah, that was fun. All right, that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.